Welcome you all, myself Professor Shilpa Raut from KKVA College of Pharmacy, Nasik. Today we are going to see the topic Solvation, Association and Solubility Parameter. Solvation is a phenomenon in which solvent interact with the molecules or ions of solute, which leads to stabilization of solute spaces in the solution. Okay, means what happen as you add your solute molecule in the solvent, it start to stabilize within the solute molecule, solvent molecule, and this stabilization process is known as the solvation. In solvated state, an ion in the solution is surrounded or complexed by solvent molecules. Means if your solute is ionic in nature, then ions of your solute is surrounded by the solvent molecule. Say for example, sodium chloride is having a positively charged sodium ion and negatively charged chloride ion. These ion dissociated from the crystal lattice as this sodium chloride entered into the water. Then the ions are in the solution surrounded by the water molecule, and the ions said to be solvated or dissolved in an aqueous solution. This is the diagrammatic presentation. That is, this is the lattice of this crystal of the sodium chloride. Then this dissociated into the sodium and chloride. Then these sodium ions surrounded by the water molecule, and again this chloride is also surrounded by this water molecule, that is the solvent molecule. Water is polar solvent with negatively and positively charged region. For the negatively charged region, oxygen is responsible, and for positive charge, hydrogen is responsible. The charge region is attracted to the ion with opposite charge. Hence, positively charged region of water molecules are attracted to chloride ions, and negatively charged region of water molecule attracted to sodium ions. Means within the water molecule, hydrogen, that is the positively charged part of this water molecule, attracted towards the chloride, while oxygen is attracted towards the sodium ion. When a similar water molecules surrounding ions in a crystal, the sum of the attractive forces between the water molecules and the ion may become strong enough to overcome the attractive forces between the cation and anion. This force of attraction between the sodium and chloride is broken down by this water molecule and surrounded to this ion. The water molecules form a shell of solvation around the ion, and water surrounded ion can break away from the crystal, and ion have become a solvated in a water molecule. Then we'll move to the next point, that is the coordination and solvation number in the solvation process. It reflects a simple idea that solvation of ion or molecule consists of coordination of solute and solvent molecules. Now the coordination number is defined as a number of solvent molecules in the first coordination sphere of an ion in the solution. And suppose for the single sodium ion surrounded by the three molecules of the water, then coordination number of these complexes 3. Now say next is the solvation number is defined as the number of solvent molecule per ion that remain attached in given ion long enough to experience its translational moments. Solvation number is defined as the number of solvent molecules per ion that remain attached to given ion long enough to experience its translational moments. The solvation number of ion in a solvent depends upon reference ion as well as the method of measurement. Smaller the anion or cation, more its solvation, and greater its solvation number and solvation energy. And size of your ion is smaller, then greater number of solvation and greater solvation energy, and greater will be your solvation process. Now we'll see factors affecting on the solvation. First, that is the surface area of the solvent, then agitation, then temperature. All these factors are directly proportional to the solvation. Surface area of solvent increases, the solvation process increases, then agitation increases, then due to the agitation there is a movement of the solute molecule in the vicinity of solvent and increases the solvation. Then as the temperature increases, then kinetic energy of the molecule is increases. And as the kinetic energy of molecules increases, the interaction between the solute solvent is also increases, and it enhances the solvation. That's why all these factors are directly proportional to the solvation process. Now we'll move to the next point, that is the association. It is a vice versa case of the solvation. In case of solvation, dissociation of the ions from the crystal lattice in the solvent, and in case of association, combining of these different ionic spaces and form these special chemical entities. Association or ion association is a chemical reaction in which oppositely charged ions come together to form a distinct chemical entity. It can be classified based on number of ions that associated with each other. Accordingly, they can be classified into ion pairs and ion triplets. Again, these ion pairs further classified according to nature of interaction. First, that is the fully solvated. Second, solvent shared or solvent separated. Then third one is the contact. These are the three types of the ion pairs. The cation and anion are separated as a blue or red color respectively. If you see this diagram, blue color is of cation and red is of anion. If you see this first diagram, that is the fully solvated, second, that is the solvent shared, and third is the contact. The area surrounding ion are representing solvent molecules in the primary association cell. Secondary association is ignored. When both ions have a complete primary association sphere, the ion pair may be termed as fully solvated. Okay, there is a complete primary association sphere is separate for the both the ions. When there is about one solvent molecule between cation and anion, the ion pair may be termed as shared or solvent separated ion pair. In case of first type what happened, separate associations pair is there for each ion. In case of second type, that is the solvent shared type, the solvent ion is shared by the two anion or cation. Means one anion and one cation surrounded by the single molecule of the solvent. The solvent molecule is shared in between these two ions. That's why it is known as the solvent shared or solvent separated. Finally, the ions are in contact with each other. The ion pair is termed as contact ion pair. In this type, ion as well as the solvent molecules are contact with the each other. An ion triplet may be formed from one cation and two anion, or from one anion and two cations. Now we move to the next part, that is the statements of Coulomb's law. The force of attraction and repulsion between two electrically charged objects is directly proportional to magnitude of charge and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. Hence, according to Coulomb's second law, force of attraction or repulsion between these two charged objects, that is F, then Q1 and Q2 are electrically charged objects, D is the distance between the center of these two charged objects, and K is the constant that depend on the medium in which these charged objects are placed. Now we'll see the factors affecting on association. First, magnitude of electric charges is directly proportional to association, means as the magnitude of electric charges increases, association increases. Then dielectric constant increases, then solvation decreases. This dielectric constant is inversely proportional to the association, while the distance between the ion is also inversely proportional to the association. The next part is the solubility parameter and its determination. The solubility parameter is numerical value that indicates the relative solvency behavior of specific solvent. The various scales available to determine the solubility parameter, that is Curie butanol number, then solubility grade, then aromatic character, aniline cloud point, then wax number, heptane number, then Hildebrand solubility number, Hildebrand solubility parameter is applicable for almost all system and hence is the most widely used among these all parameter. This is the one of the selective parameter applicable for almost all systems. Sometimes only numerical value for these terms are encountered, while at other times value are presented in the form of two or three dimensional graph and triangular graph called a T's graph. It is used because of its accuracy and clarity. Then the solubility behavior of unknown substance often gives a clue to its identification, and the change in the solubility of known material can provide essential information about its aging characteristics. Means if the solubility behavior is changes, there might be the chances of aging of your substance. Our choice of solvent in a particular situation involves many factors. for example evaporation rate, then solvation solution viscosity, then environmental and health concerns, and often the effectiveness of solvent depend on its ability to adequately dissolve material. It should be noted that these systems relate to non-ionic liquid interactions. That are extended to polymer interaction, water-based system, and those system involving acid-base reaction cannot be evaluated by simply solubility parameter system alone. It is the van der Waals forces which is reflected in the simplest solubility value. The Hildebrand solubility parameter it is derived from the cohesive energy of solvent, which in turn is derived from heat of vaporization. The relationship between vaporization, then van der Waals forces and solubility will help us to clarify this. We'll see first point, that is the vaporization. When liquid is heated to its boiling point, the energy is added to liquid, resulting in increase in temperature of liquid. Once liquid reaches its boiling point, however, for the addition of heat does not causes for the increase in temperature. The energy that is added is entirely used to separate the molecules of liquid and boil them and away into gas. Then only when the liquid has been completely vaporized will the temperature of the system again begins to rise. Means as you give the heat to the particular solution, the temperature of your solution or the solvent increases up to its boiling point. After reaching this boiling point, immediately your molecules of the solvent start to evaporate and convert it into the gas. And when it is completely converted into the gas, then again it starts to increase the temperature. If we measure the amount of energy that was added from the onset of the boiling to the point when all liquid has boiled away, we will have a direct indication of amount of energy required to separate liquid into gas, and thus the amount of van der Waals forces that held the molecule of liquid together. Means after vaporization, you will get the idea how much energy is required to break these van der Waals forces. Then next is the cohesive energy density. From the heat of vaporization in calories per cubic centimeter of liquid, we can derive the cohesive energy density by following expression, that is C is equal to delta T minus RT upon Vm, where C is the cohesive energy density, then delta H is the heat of vaporization, R is the gas constant, and T is the temperature. Then Vm is the molar volume. In other words, the cohesive energy density of liquid is numerical value that indicates the energy of vaporization in calories per cubic centimeter and is direct reflection of degree of van der Waals forces holding the molecules of liquid together. Next is the solubility parameter. In 1936, Joel H. Hildebrand, who laid the foundation of solubility theory, in his classic work on solubility of non-electrolytes in 1960 proposed the square root of cohesive energy density as a numerical value indicating the solvency behavior of the particular solvent. Okay, means these under root of the cohesive energy density is the solubility parameter. Then unit of measurement of the solubility parameter is the SI unit for expressing the pressure is Pascal, and the SI Hildebrand solubility parameter are expressed in megapascal, that is 1 megapascal is equal to MPa is equal to 1 million Pascal. Conveniently, SI parameter are about twice the value of standard parameter. Then we'll see application of the solubility parameter. First, for the solvent spectrum, based on solubility parameter value we can rank the solvent. Suppose the substance is soluble in acetone, then substance might be soluble in solvents having a nearly delta value. Means if sodium chloride is soluble in water, then if other solvent is having a solubility parameter like water, then again the sodium chloride is able to solubilize into the other solvent. Then second is the solvent mixture. The Hildebrand value of the solvent mixture can be determined by averaging the Hildebrand value of individual solvent by volume. Say for example, the solubility parameter value of acetone is 14.5 and glycerin is 17.5, and when we took these both in 1:1 ratio, then solubility parameter of this mixture will be 16.1. Then the delta value for ethylene glycol is 16.1. So that each substance, if the substance is soluble in 1:1 mixture of acetone and glycerin, then it will also soluble in ethylene glycol due to the same solubility parameter value. Means if the two substances having or two solvent is having the same solubility parameter, then in that particular solute, if you try to solubilize one single solute, then solubility should be same. Okay, this is all about the solvation, association and solubility parameter. Thank you.